While the evidence for increased cancer risk was weak and inconsistent, the panel conceded that some degree of important health effects for individuals exposed to PFAS cannot be ruled out. In 2015, it emerged that the chemicals used for decades in Scotch Guard and fire retardants had contaminated land at 22 defense bases nationally. Class actions have since been launched in communities such as Williamtown, north of Newcastle, and Catherine, in the Northern Territory, where property values are in free fall and residents are living with strict precautions around the use of their land. A spokesman for the Williamtown Class Action Steering Committee blasted the announcement as a complete abdication of responsibility from the government. "They have a clear conflict. Here is the defendant in one of the largest environmental class actions in Australia," he said. "What is most appalling is that, once again, communities like Williamtown around Australia have been left with no answers. As has been pointed out by the Royal College of Physicians, there is now a massive contradictory advice." In March, the Royal Australasian College of Physicians was scathing of the federal government's health advice that there was no consistent evidence of health effects from PFAS. The organization, which represents more than 25,000 medical specialists, said the advice was confusing for the public and did not take into account the international evidence. Government of Australia, read full story. More health.